In this video, we will study about the coastal plains and the islands of India. What is coastal plain? A coastal plain is a flat, low-lying land adjacent to a seacoast. An island is a landmass surrounded on all sides by water. We will do in detail the western and the eastern coastal plains of India, the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, the Lakshadweep Islands, and the life in these areas. In the previous video, we learned that the southern plateau covers most of the Indian peninsula. The plateau is surrounded by narrow coastal plains on the eastern and the western sides. On the west, between the Western Ghats and the Arabian Sea, is the western coastal plain. And on the east, between the Eastern Ghats and the Bay of Bengal, is the eastern coastal plains. The western coastal plain. It begins from Gujarat in the north and passes through Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka and Kerala. It is divided into three main parts: the Gujarat coast in the north, the Konkan coast in the middle up to Goa, the Malabar coast in the south from Goa to Kanyakumari. If we will talk about the eastern coastal plain, then it begins from West Bengal in the north and passes through Odisha, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. The western coastal plains and the eastern coastal plains, they meet at Kanyakumari, the southernmost tip of the peninsula. The northern part of the eastern coastal plain is called the Northern Circus and southern part is called as the Coromandel Coast. India has also two groups of islands, the Andaman and Nicobar Islands in the Bay of Bengal and the Lakshadweep Island in the Arabian Sea. Gujarat lies in the northwest of India. Its capital is Gandhinagar. Trading and farming are the main occupations of the people of state. Main agricultural products are jowar, bajra, sugarcane, cotton, groundnut and tobacco. Gujarat has several well-developed industries like textiles, petroleum, fertilizers, diamond cutting industries, handloom industries. Dairy farming is also an important industry in Gujarat. The famous Amul milk products come from Anand in Gujarat. The main language spoken in the state is Gujarati, and the women wear saris and lehengas, and men traditionally wear churidars or dhoti with short jackets or angarakhas. Ahmedabad is the largest city of Gujarat, and Gandhiji's Sabarmati Ashram lies in this city. The Gir Forest, which is the home of Asiatic lion, is important tourist attractions here. The Konkan coast runs through Maharashtra. Mumbai is the summer capital of Maharashtra and Nagpur is the winter capital. The seabed of the Konkan coast has large deposits of petroleum. The region is called the Bombay High. And as we go south from Goa along the coast, we come to Karnataka. Bengaluru is the capital of Karnataka, which is called as the Garden City. Mangalore is an important seaport. To the south of Maharashtra is the small and beautiful state of Goa. Its capital is Panjim. The main industries in Goa are mining and tourism. It has beautiful beaches and churches that attract tourists all over the world. In the extreme south of the western coastal plain lies the beautiful state of Kerala, also called as God's own country. Its capital is Thiruvananthapuram. Kochi is an important seaport of Kerala. Kerala is very famous for its spices, coconut, cashew, coffee and rubber. Almost the entire population of Kerala knows how to read and write. The main language is Malayalam. Onam and Vishu are important festivals of Kerala. Boat races in which long boats called snake boats take part are held during Onam. The races are great tourist attraction. Kathakali is the traditional dance form of Kerala. Kerala has number of beautiful beaches and the most famous being the Kovalam Beach. The lagoons or backwaters of Kerala, the wildlife sanctuary and the famous temples are other tourist attractions. As we move along the coast towards the south from West Bengal, we come to Odisha. Its capital is Bhubaneswar. The delta formed by Mahanadi River is very fertile. The main crop grown over here is rice. The main industries are handloom, jewelry and decorative items, and mining. Odia is the main language spoken over here. Odissi is the popular dance form of Odisha. Lots of people turn up to see the Rath Yatra of Puri. The temples at Bhubaneswar, Puri and Konark are the other tourist attractions. Andhra Pradesh, its capital is Hyderabad. Visakhapatnam, a city on the coast, is a major port and shipbuilding center. It also has an oil refinery and an iron and steel plant. Tamil Nadu. Chennai is the capital of Tamil Nadu. It lies on the Coromandel coast. The Marina Beach in the city is the longest natural beach in India. The delta formed by Kaveri River is very fertile. It is called the rice bowl of Tamil Nadu. Kanyakumari in Tamil Nadu is the southernmost tip of the Indian mainland. The Vivekananda Rock Memorial has been built on a small island near the coast called Vivekananda Rock. As we go south from Chennai along the coast, we come to the Union Territory of Puducherry. It is famous for Aurobindo Ashram. Lakshadweep Island is Union Territory. The capital of this Union Territory is Kavaratti. The major industries in Lakshadweep Island are coir making, fishing and tourism. The beautiful islands and beaches attract many tourists. Andaman and Nicobar Islands. The capital of Andaman and Nicobar Island is Port Blair. Only few of the islands are inhabited. Most of these people live in forest, in groups or in tribes. The cellular jail at Port Blair was once used by British to imprison Indian freedom fighters. Tourism is an important industry because of its beautiful beaches. Coconut and rice are the main agriculture products. Thank you. If you like my video, please like it and subscribe it. Thanks a lot.